You're listening to Stream Mix Radio.
CFMAM Productions.
Blah, 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 blah. Oh, man. Radio has gotten boring.
Don't worry. We have a procedure for these situations.
Hey! Let's go! Let's go!
Music Lovers Radio and Freestyle Lovers Radio. Radio stations bringing back the fun.
You may take a break.
Not us.
We never take a break. We're always on. MiamiMikeRadio.com. Music 24/7.
You're in the mix. In the mix. 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 On Classic 407.
407.
Bang. Bang it. All the hits.
Clipper.fm.
You're listening to Vibe 24/7.
24/7.
Banging all the hits you love. Feel the vibe.
LMC Radio. Playing music to touch your heart.
Touch your heart.
And your mind to make you feel good.
FreestyleForever.com.
Latino 407. La emisora donde vive el corazón de nuestra gente.
So beautiful.
Happy Sunday, everyone. This is Little Marla coming to you from the Extreme Mix Studio and CFMAM Productions. DJ Lex presents Freestyle Spotlight, The People's Countdown. Now here are your hosts, DJ Lex and DJ Noel Nice.
All right, happy Sunday, buddy. Happy Sunday. Noel, what's going on?
Hey, man, happy Sunday, bro. Happy Sunday, everybody. Everybody listening in, everybody in the chat room tuning in.
Yeah.
How's everybody doing? We're back, actually.
We're back,
You know, finally. I know we had a couple of shows, you know, with the interview with Sami Zayn and of course, the number one songs of 2022. But we're actually back on the top 15 countdown.
That's right.
You know, the countdown is back. So we're, I guess you could say, the official normal show is back as of today. So
that's right.
I see that you you put on some Akon, Alex. What's up with that?
Oh man, I like Akon. And remember that time when Akon came out, a lot of artists were sampling those break beats. Remember, it was like early 2000s.
Yeah, that's a nice song. Beautiful. So it's really nice. He's got a, you know, of course, he's got an incredible voice. So anything that he sings is going to sound nice.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's really good. And again, you know, shout out to everybody, all the radio stations, everybody listening on them.
Yeah.
Everybody in the chat room, again, as you're coming in, you know, sharing is caring.
Yes.
So if you guys popping in, you know, if you could, you know, share with, you know, through Messenger or, you know, Facebook, whatever, you know, get some people in here.
Yeah.
And those that you know, that like the show. And if you're listening on this, one of the stations, you know, pop on in. You know, you're more than welcome.
Yeah.
To be in the chat room with us, so you can, you know, not only hear, but you can see. Let me ask you, well, not ask you, but yesterday, Alex, I went to the movies with my daughter.
Oh, you did?
And we went to see, so we went to see that that movie, Megan.
Yeah.
I don't know if you're familiar with it.
Yeah, I'm familiar.
Megan.
How was it?
That movie was absolutely crazy.
Oh, yeah?
If you haven't seen that movie yet, you need to go see it. Whoever's listening, go do yourself a favor and go see Megan. And you say, well, what's Megan? What's the big deal? Well, it's this, I guess you could say, robotic doll, I guess, to some degree. Artificial intelligence, Alex.
Yeah.
What do you think about that? What are you, know, if you have any, thoughts.
Well,
that movie was incredible. It was done, before you continue, it was incredible. You have to go watch it. I think it was produced or directed by same guy that does the Fast and Furious the Fast and Furious movies.
Okay, yeah.
So you know it's. I knew it was somebody big because the way that movie is, it was done.
Yeah.
It's fantastic. I mean, it gets you from minute one to the very. In fact, I'll tell you what. I'll even go a step further. We were waiting. There was a couple other people waiting in the theater after it was done. To see if there was any additional credits. Mind you, typically it's Marvel movies that do that.
Yeah.
You know, the post-scene credits, things like that. And of course, we do a little something like that here on the show.
Yeah.
Once in a while. But it's typically those movies that do that. And we were standing there all the way through the credits.
Mm-hmm.
You know, although I already know they're already coming out with a part two to that in a couple of years.
Okay.
They're already working on it. Yeah. But the point is, AI and how it can terribly go wrong.
Yes, it can, yeah.
You know, and the reality is that we're in the midst of that, and it's only just the beginning.
Yeah.
You know, so I don't know. Any thoughts on that, Alex? You know, artificial intelligence? I mean, look, we all deal with it. We all use it to some degree. If you're using Alexa, if you're using, you know, Siri, all these, those, you know, those are, that's all AI.
Yeah.
But I mean, I know of some AI that's on her level and even beyond, which is crazy.
In the 80s, there was a TV show with a little girl who was an AI who played as a daughter to the family. Can't remember the exact name. And then there was a movie which this girl had, this girl that passed away in the movie, and they put an AI chip in her. And that AI chip went wrong. She became she started killing everybody, you know? Can't remember the name of it, but it was good too.
Yeah, so, you know, I mean, it's supposedly it's meant to help, and it can. It could be very helpful.
Yeah.
But it could also go terribly wrong. So, you know, we all use it. It's really here to stay, and it's going to affect us. You know, like I told my daughter, so you're this age now, but when you're my age, which is going to be a lot further in the future, you're going to look back to like a day like today and say, you know, plus your world is going to be a whole lot different than what it is right now. Yeah. You know, AI is going to be a big part of it, a much bigger part.
Yeah.
You know, for better or worse, you know, but, you know, it's here to stay. So anyway, moving on. What do we got, Alex?
All right, we got a top 15 countdown.
Top 15.
We're gonna do a recap real quick from 15 to 11, and then we start off some music from there. You ready?
Hey, man, let's do it. Let's do it.
All right, let's go. Because we're recapping from where we left off at the beginning of December.
This is going to be interesting, Alex. Yeah. This is going to be very interesting.
It is, yeah. All right, at number 15.
We're going to see where we left off, and we're going to see...
Yeah, at number 15 number 15 was Gennaro with Those Eyes. Number 14 was Lamar featuring Marilyn Torres with Yesterday. Number 13 was Deneen with Last Chance. Number 12 was Mari Angeli Lopez with First True Love. And at number 11 is a debut by Stephanie Bennett. It's called Cupid's Arrow, the Bastrix Radio Mix. You know, congratulations for Stephanie being able to make it onto the countdown with a recent track. And I know you created a cover for the CD.
Yeah. I created the cover for that Cupid's Arrow for her. She asked me, and I definitely did that.
Yeah. All right, so let's go into the countdown because I know everybody's waiting for the music. Coming in number 10 this week on the countdown, making its 18th appearance on the show, was number 12 last time it was on.
Good.
At number 10, he is Jay Rivera with Insanity.
Now is a mystery.
Chart number 10 this week in the countdown, that was Jay Rivera with Insanity. Coming in at number 9 this week in the countdown, making its 8th appearance in the show, was number 5 last time it was on. And number 9, here's Niaja featuring Sapphire and Kenny Diaz with Walk Away, the 1018 mix.
Thank you.
All right, show number 9 this week in the countdown. That was Naija featuring Sapphire and Kenny Diaz with Walk Away, the 1018 mix. Coming number 8 this week in the countdown, making its 9th appearance in the show, was number 3 last time it was on. And number 8, here is Jesse B with Cause It's You. Channel number 8 this week in the countdown, that was Jesse B with Cause It's You. Coming number 7 this week in the countdown, making its first appearance on the show, brand new to the countdown. At number 7, here's Romero with Where Do I Belong?
Really real right now, I'm lost within my touch. I'm in and out of touch. It's tearing me apart. I wonder if they see deep in my eyes that it's all that I've been through. A feeling of despair is lurking everywhere, and still I fake a smile. The minutes tick on by. I'm trying not to cry. Dear Lord, help me make it through. And it's torture in my soul with all this pain I can't control. I'm feeling lost, I'm feeling alone, but I need to know, where do I belong and where do I begin again? I lost so much in my life. Dear Lord, please help me find the answers. Where do I belong and where do I go from here? So much has messed me by. Dear Lord, please tell me now, where do I belong?
Chart number 7 this week in the countdown. That was Romero with Where Do I Belong. Coming number 6 this week in the countdown, making its 21st appearance in the show, was number 11 last time we was on. And number 6 here's Karina with Take Me Away, the New Era Remix. All right, show number 6 this week in the countdown. That was Karina with Take Me Away, the New Era Remix.
The New Era Remix.
Yes.
Yeah, that's a really good one. Yes, I mean, obviously, that's the one we always play. And, yeah.
And it's been on the countdown for 21 weeks, man. That's a long time on the countdown.
Hey, you know what? Peter, you listening, or if you're in the chat room, man, you've done a really good job with that remix.
Yes, he is. Yeah.
And it's at number 6. So it's not like it's in the countdown at 12 or 13 or anything like that. It's at number 6.
Yeah.
I mean, mm-hmm. And I think when we left off last year, I think it was in the top 5. If I remember, I think it was in the top 5. I can't remember.
It was more in the top 10. It was just floating around. And it seems that since that break that we took, and the fans voted onto it and brought it even closer down to the top 6, which is good, you know?
So I brought it up. So, yeah. Okay. Yeah, same thing with Jay Rivera with Insanity. It was it was out of the top 10. It was, I think, 12 or something like that?
Yeah.
Here it is, back in the top 10.
Yeah.
And that goes to show that, you know, these songs, you would think, well, you know, it's kind of falling back, it's going down in the, you know, falling down in the countdown. It's not, no, these songs can go right back up.
That's right. Yeah,
you know, with the voting, with, you know, a lot of the different things going on that can bring it up, you know, videos.
Yeah.
You know, there's a lot of elements of things, so don't think because your song is, you know, kind of creeping down on the countdown that it's, you know, it's a done deal, you know. What I mean, I mean, like you said, you know, Karina, Take Me Away, the New Era Remix, 21 weeks in a row.
Yeah.
You know, and it's, you know, up and down.
Yeah.
You know, and Jay Rivera, like I said, he was out of the top 10. Now he's back in the top 10.
Mm-hmm.
And there's not really anything new that's happened. So
yeah.
I think now we have five, count them, 1, 2, 3, 5 debuts coming
up.
Yeah. I believe one of them is from Jenna Liz, Complicated. Is that correct, Alex?
That's correct, yeah.
One of them, yeah. So, shout-outs to, you know, Yu-Yo and everybody, Jenna Liz. See what, you know, hey, we gave everybody an opportunity. We play it on. We put it on the debuts, and, you know, we'll see. We'll see what happens.
Let's see what happens, yeah. And it's our first debut here on the Freestyle Spotlight Countdown with Jenny Liz with Complicated. It's available to be voted into the countdown, so you guys decided and voted in on the song. Our second debut here on the Freestyle Spotlight is coming from Luis Guarez, and it's called Rescue Me.
I know the truth in
All right, so that was a second to beat here in a Freestyle Spotlight Countdown. This came from Luis Guavares with Rescue. Also eligible to be voted into the countdown. Now coming in our third debut this week on the countdown, it's coming from Nelson Rigo, and the track is called Surrender to Me. All right, so that was our third debut here on the Freestyle Spotlight, coming from Nelson Riegel with Surrender to Me, and also is qualified to be voted into the countdown. Our fourth debut is coming from Luis Marte, and the track is called The Chase. Fourth debut in the countdown, that was Luis Marte with The Chase, also available for to be voted into the countdown. Now here's our fifth debut on the countdown, and we got a lot of debuts this week, you know, so our fifth debut on the countdown is coming from Suave, and it's called Baby Don't Go. All right, Joe, that was our fifth debut here on the Freestyle Spotlight. That was Suave with Baby Don't Go. Also, eligible to be voted into the countdown.
Noel? Baby Don't Go, yeah. That.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, those debuts, pretty good, I think. And you know, I think probably, I don't know, I'd probably say, I don't want to pick. I don't like picking. You know, I let the fans vote and pick them. That, you know, we're just here to play them. But
that's it.
I think they're all pretty good.
And they're all, all eligible to be voted into the countdown. So you guys decide whether they come on next week.
That is the thing. And that's how we always continue to move forward. Because, again, this is all brand new music. And, you know, we give everybody an opportunity. You know, we had, you know, like I said, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 debuts. And you know, to start off the year, that's pretty good.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Nice. And I think, Alex, if I am not correct, we have a bonus.
That's right. We got a
debut.
Bonus. Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
So we not only have 5, we actually have 6.
That's
now
right.
This debut, for those listening, this debut almost costed us $500.
That's right, yeah.
But we were able to manage to get it for a much, much reduced price.
Yes.
And that debut is, Alex?
It's Sharon Massarin with Numb, the Starlet Vegas remix.
Sharon Massarin with Numb.
Yeah.
Yes, that is our bonus. So you guys didn't know that.
Yeah.
But then again, you just never know what we're going to do.
That's right.
Sharon Massarin, Numb. It was not $500.
No.
But here it is on the Freestyle Spotlight Countdown.
There you go.
Yeah.
All right, so that was the final debut here on a Freestyle Spotlight. Coming from Sharon Masson with Numb, the Starlet and Vegas remix. Also eligible to be voted into the countdown. All right, now it's time for our top five right here on the Freestyle Spotlight countdown. At number five, making its fourth appearance in the show and was number four last time we was on. At number five, here's Luis Marte and Tenero with Falling, the White Label mix. At number five, this is going to count. And that was Luis Martin and Gennaro with Falling, the White Label mix. Coming in number four, this is going to count. That making its 19th appearance on the show was number 9 last week, and it's trying to make its comeback. At number 4, here's Mambo LeBron featuring Chrissy Hines with Take Me Away.
Let's take it to the streets.
Your love knocking me out like Ali. The essence of your presence, godly. The creme de la creme, with kids and hams. You don't need no other body. Take you away to the Fiji island. Just to hear you say, would you do the assignment? Trip you a diamond ring to find the thing. Show you why I'm the king, queen, sing.
You looked at me, all I can see.
right, John, number four, this week in the countdown, that was Mamba LeBron featuring Chrissy Ice, Take Me Away. Coming to number three this week in the countdown, making its 21st appearance on the show, was number six last time that we was on, and it's making a comeback. At number three, here's Brenda K. Starr with The Only One I Love, the Club Jumpers remix. Right, y'all, number three this week on the countdown, that was Brenda K. Starr with The Only One I Love, the Club Jumpers remix. Coming in number two this week on the countdown, making its 11th appearance in the show, was number two last time we were on. And number two, here's Rebecca with Enough.
song.
Channel number two, this is gonna count. That was Rebecca with Enough.
Rebecca at number two. I told you, I told her, I should say,
yeah,
that I don't remember what she was at when we finished our last year, our regular countdown before we jumped into the top 30.
She was in about the top five last year, which I remember.
She was in the top five,
yes.
So she's moving up. And
yeah.
I know when we did the top 30, she ended up number five overall,
yes,
mm-hmm. you know, for the year,
yeah.
And I told her, I said, your song could very well continue to move upwards,
yes.
you know, into the new year, into now into the 20s. I told her that last year.
Yeah.
And here we are with Rebecca Enough at number two. At number two. So, Rebecca, if you're listening, hopefully you're in the chat room. That's why you guys, you know, that's why we do these shows, you know, pop in.
Yeah.
And if you're listening, you know, you're at number two, so... I don't know. Yeah. I could mean, you know, you can hit that number one spot, and
that's right, yeah.
if you hit that number one spot, even for 1 week, you are guaranteed a spot at the end of the year, top number one.
That's right.
Songs of 2023 mix.
That's right.
So all you need is at least one week at number one.
That's
so everybody,
it.
You like Rebecca? She's very underrated. I always say she's very yes. underrated. Mm-hmm. She's probably, I think she's got some more stuff coming down.
Yeah.
I think she posted so. Mm-hmm. But right now, Enough is at number two.
Yeah.
So keep voting. And another thing, uh-huh. Mamba LeBron featuring Chrissy Ais, Take Me Away at number four.
Yeah, they're coming back
again,
up.
Moving back up.
Yes. Yeah.
But what was she at when we... I know she was the number one song overall.
But. Yeah, but the last time that we was on with the countdown, she was at number nine. So now she's moving up.
Number nine.
Yeah.
So that means that she's moving back up.
Yeah.
See, again, this is what I was saying earlier. You can it can fluctuate, and a song like that,
yeah,
can easily move right back up. So she holds the record currently, because I don't know who the number one is yet.
Yeah.
Probably figure it out, but she currently holds the number one record for 9 weeks in a row at
nine
number
weeks,
one
yes.
straight, but.
Mm-hmm.
She could return to that number one spot. I don't know. It's looking like they're climbing back up, and I say they because you know Mamba LeBron.
Possible battle between her and C Rank. You never know.
Are you trying? Hey, are you insinuating something that C Rank is number one this week?
Yeah, of course. Everybody knows that. So yes, he's number one.
Everybody
this week.
Knows that.
And
that's the only song that has not been played.
Yeah, and of course now she is tied with. Chrissy Ais and 9 weeks.
Very good point.
Yes.
With this now, she is now correct. You're correct. So now, no. So now this is very interesting.
Yeah.
Not only now they're both tied at number nine. Mm. excuse me. 9 weeks in a row at number one in a row.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So this week, as of this week, they're tied. we'll see what happens next week. So I tell you what, if this continues with Mamba, LeBron, and Chrissy going back up next week, it could very well be Chrissy Ayesha again at number one.
You never know. Yeah, that's
true. Or it could be C-Bank at number one. Mm-hmm. But you know who decides that? You guys decide.
Fans,
that.
Yeah.
Your voters, fans, you guys decide. And we'll see next week. It'll be very interesting.
And remember, she became the number one song for 2022. That gave her a big boost now, you know?
Yeah, and I see it, and I've seen in a lot of, actually, you know what? I've seen a lot of other countdowns and stuff, or, you know, surveys or whatever they do. I do see in some mixes, I have seen Mamba, LeBron, and Chrissy at the number one, you know, and some other countdowns and stuff like that, or, you know, voting and stuff like that. And C-Bank, there's, you know, there seems to be a bit of a
rivalry,
a battle.
Yes.
Yeah. It seems to be those two, and the quality of these songs is really what it's understandable.
Yes.
It really is understandable.
Yes,
I mean, Heaven, you know, with C-Bank, you know, with Carlos Berry's beautiful song, video is amazing, and the same thing can be said with Chrissy Ayesha and Mamba LeBron.
Yes, same thing.
The song's dope. The video's dope. Yep. It's just it's you know, they're tit for tat right now.
Yeah.
You know, so right now, they're both tied for the most weeks at number one at 9 apiece.
Yes,
so we have a tie. Yeah. So obviously, you know, let's hit them with the number one song. We know C-Bank, Heaven.
Yeah,
I call this song, the video and everything, perfect. It's just a perfect combination.
That's
and
right.
The perfect video, the perfect type of video for the perfect song.
Mm-hmm.
And she, you know, she just does an amazing job. The way you know, she goes back and forth. You know, the way, you know, it was edited. You know, Carlos Berrios. And you know,
they did a great job.
Phenomenal
on
what they do.
Mm-hmm. And plus Sammy Zone on the track as well, topped it off.
Sammy Zone. And I tell you what, when these guys work together, it's like, whether it's Sammy singing, whether it's C-Bank singing, they, you know, they sing back, you know, backgrounds for each other or background vocals.
Yeah.
And it's just, it's always icing on the cake.
Yes,
you know,
it is,
it's
yeah,
like, man. it's like a perfect combination. It's like their you know, it's like their voices are like intertwined or something.
Yes.
You know, it's perfection.
That's right.
It is perfection. So, it's music to my ears, literally. And I know, obviously, by the way these songs are constantly at the top, it's music to everybody else's ears as
well.
So,
all right, so let's say our goodbyes before we play the song. You know, shout out to all the radio stations, you know.
Yeah, shout out to everybody listening. Shout out to the radio station owners, moderators of those stations and this station. You know, in the chat room, those new people that have popped in, because there's usually one or two people that come into the chat room for the first time, or if you're one of those new people that are listening on one your particular station that we're broadcasting live onto, you know, shout outs to you as well, and we appreciate you.
Yes.
And you're always welcome in the chat room, and if not, you can always listen to us, you know, whatever station, you know, that you're listening to us from on Sundays, 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And we got some other things coming up. And also, you know, on my YouTube channel afterwards, you can check us out at my DJ Know All Nights YouTube channel.
Mm.
If you don't get a chance, or if you want to just kind of recap and rewatch the whole show again, you can check it out there. And, you know, we'll have some more news and stuff that we're working on as well as
stay tuned. We're going to be soon on Ruko TV, which is awesome.
That's right. So again, we'll have some more information on that as that kind of develops and you know, we kind of get into the flow of that. But right now we got what we have, and we have the number one song to start off the year 2023, C-Bank with Heaven.
There you go.
Let's go, Alex.
We'll see you next week.
you to see the look upon your face.
Man, radio has gotten boring.
Don't worry, we have a procedure for these situations.
Hey, let's go, let's go!
Music Lovers Radio and Freestyle Lovers Radio. Radio stations bringing back the fun.
You may take a break.
Not us.
We never take a break. We're always on. MiamiMikeRadio.com. Music 24/7.
You're in the mix. In the mix.
Mix. Mix.
On Classic 407.
407.
Bang it.
Bang it.
All the hits.
Clipper.fm.
You're listening to Vibe 24/7.
24/7.
Banging all the hits you love. Feel the vibe.
LMC Radio. Playing music to touch your heart.
Touch your heart.
And your mind to make you feel good.
FreestyleForever.com.
Latino 407. La emisora donde vive el corazón de nuestra gente.
Noel, you still there?
Yeah, man. Yeah, still there?
Yeah, I'm still here. Yeah. No, I was thinking if Chrissy Hayes makes it back to number one, and if they end up being tied at the same points with C-Bank, that could be some hell of a battle.
Yeah, man, that'd be crazy. Yo.
Yeah, yeah.
That'd be crazy that next week. It can happen next week.
Yeah, it can.
I mean, literally, next week we can have a tie at number one if, you know, obviously if everybody, you know, we get a jump. And obviously they're getting a big push because, you know, to jump from number nine to four.
Yeah.
You know, Mamba, LeBron, and Chrissy. So to jump that much, I wouldn't be surprised if they jump another three spots. And then before you know it, next week we have a tie at number one.
Yeah, you never know. Yeah.
So that's crazy.
That's gonna be a first on Freestyle Spotlight. So this is gonna be good.
You know what? It's gonna be that tension's gonna be bro. It is gonna be so tight, that race, so tight and so close. You got to cut it with a knife. And in this particular case, I'm going to be cutting that with a sword right here. See that?
Look at that sword.
See the sword right there?
Yeah, yeah.
Look at that.
Nice.
Look at that. That's how tight. You're going to use a sword like this to cut that tie up possibly coming up next week or really anytime now because of what it looks like. You know, Mamba, LeBron, and Chrissy's moving back up. So I don't know. It can get tight. You get tight. It's going to be very interesting, but it's going to be up to the people, you know?
That's right.
Yeah. It is what it is. We'll see.
Yeah.